it's Jessica from Peace Love Books, and today I'm here with a video that I don't think I've done at all this year. It's a hard video to do, and that is my most anticipated reads for the rest of the year. I read so many indie romances, and they don't really announce their releases until like maybe 3 months before they release, and so it's really hard at the beginning of the year to talk about what you're excited for the entire year. So I just didn't do this at the beginning of the year, but we only have 4 months left of the year, right? September, October, November, December. Oh my gosh, 4 months left of 2022, and I have a list of about 20 books that I'm super excited for the rest of the year. Most of them are indie, but I do have a few traditionally published ones added to the mix. A lot of them are my absolute favorite authors or ones that I'm excited to come. I think most of them are ones I've read from the author before, so I'm very excited for that, but I will go ahead and get to all the books I can't wait to read for the rest of the year. I am wearing my mummy shirt that my friend Brittany got me for my birthday, since I'd rather be watching the mummy. It's so cute, I love it. So we do have a lot coming out in September, and so the first one comes out September 6th. I'm gonna try my best to do these in order. I did not write them down in order, but we have The American Roommate Experiment by Elena Armas. I'm very excited to read this. I need to read it soon because my friend sent this to me a couple weeks ago. She had an extra copy and sent it my way, and I'm very excited because I love The Spanish Love Deception, and I can't wait for her second book. This one, they have to be roommates, and our heroine is like a secret romance writer, and they have to live together. And he's gonna take her out on a series of dates in order to help her writer's block go away. I love that kind of premise. It kind of reminds me of Beach Read by Emily Henry, but very excited for this. It's also pretty long. It's almost 400 pages. Hopefully I like it. Then I have Do You Take This Man by Denise Williams. I absolutely love Denise Williams, and this one I believe is her third book with at least Berkeley. And she does have the novellas that she came out with, but full length novels, this is her third one. I really loved How to Fail at Flirting and her other one, which was like a workout kind of romance. This one sounds really fun. So it revolves around weddings, which I really love. And the heroine ends up being a last minute officiant for a wedding, and everything goes crazy. The video of the wedding goes viral and people are seeking her out to be their officiant for their wedding. And she enjoys it, but she doesn't like the wedding planner. So it says he's a former pro football event manager. I don't know if he's a former pro football player, but he is an event manager, and I think they end up having a friends with benefits situation. No, it says enemies with benefits situation, and obviously they fall in love, so I'm very excited to read this one. I love a good wedding romance, so this sounds great. Then on November 15th, I have Northern Stars by Brittany C. Cherry. This is the fourth book in her Compass series. I think I've read one or two books in this series. I'm obsessed with this cover, and this one is a Hollywood romance. The hero is the Hollywood's biggest star, and they were high school sweethearts, and they broke up, and now I think he's back in their small town, and it says that he hates her, and he's staying in the only hotel, which is the hotel that she oversees and works at, and it's their romance again. I love a good small town romance. I love a good angsty emotional romance, which is what Brittany C. Cherry always writes. Sorry, this one's under Brittany Cherry, but very excited to read this one. I love this author so much, and it's gonna be so good. I think those are all the November ones, so now we're into October. The first one, I believe, is going to be Little Too Wild by Devney Perry. This one's actually part of a series, and it's number 3, but I don't know if I'm super interested in the other two. It's like Serena Bowen and someone else, but I love Devney Perry, and it is a snowboarding romance, and sign me up. So he's a snowboarding legend, gorgeous, rich, famous, and she doesn't like famous people. She's like, give me the nerdy guy every time. I don't care about the super popular people. And it's been over a decade since he's been at Madigan Mountain, and apparently it's his brother's wedding, and he sits next to her, and he invites her to his hotel room after the wedding, and she goes. So this sounds really fun. I would love a snowboarding romance. I love sports romances. I love Devney Perry. It sounds like it's still a small town, like on their mountain town, so very excited for this one. Then we have It Starts With Us by Colleen Hoover. This one comes out October 18th, I believe, and I'm so excited for this book. This one, let me double check. This has come out October 18th. I'm very, very excited. It's Lillian Atlas's story. It's book number 2 to It Ends With Us, one of my favorite books of all time. We got like a happy for now between them, but we didn't get a full-blown romance between them. So very excited. I've already ordered my Waterstones super pretty hardback edition, and I'm probably gonna go to Target or Barnes & Noble the day it comes out and buy it, because anytime I pre-order a book online, it never comes on release day, and I need this book on release day. So I'm very excited. I'm gonna say I'm excited about every book, but this one's like one of my most anticipated books of the year. Then we also have Fractured Sky by Katherine Cowles. She does actually have one coming out in September, but I've already read it because I got an early copy of it, so that's not anticipated anymore because I loved it. But this one is the one we are all dying for. It is Shiloh's book. Shiloh was the character who was kidnapped in her childhood, and her kidnapping has affected pretty much every character of the series so far because it's mostly been her siblings that have been getting books. Not every book, but most of them is someone she's related to, and so she is very, very quiet and reserved. It doesn't like to talk to people, and it's her romance with someone who owns a horse ranch, and he works with horses, like really broken horses, and he rehabilitates them, I believe, or like tries to make them able to like be around people. And I'm so excited for this book. I have been craving it since book one, and it was funny because Catherine like was talking to me about how she had been dying to write it, and I was like, well, good, because we're all dying to read it, so I'm glad you got to suffer too. But I'm so excited. This is coming out in October. She's giving us two releases back to back. I'm super excited. She writes like 5 books ahead though, so she's had this done for a while, and I'm just like, my kid open if you want to like just send it my way, but I haven't read it yet. Not yet, but I cannot wait. I did get a little ahead of myself, so let me find. I don't think that this is completely like synopsis is out yet, but, and I also haven't read the first book by this author, but it is Heartless by Elsie Silver. This one's releasing October 14th, and I think this, yes, and so it does have a synopsis. It's Cade Eaton, who is 13 years older than her, and she is a nanny, and this says that it's forced proximity, age gap, single dad nanny, grumpy sunshine, banter and spice. Sounds really good. I'm actually gonna read Flawless this week, so I have high expectations for that one, and I'm excited for a new one to come out. And that's another thing about making these videos is so many books, even if they're only 2 months out, don't have covers yet, but this one is gonna be good, and I definitely am adding it to my TBR. Then we have Quarterback Sneak by Candy Steiner. This one is coming out on October 19th, and it just says that it is a forbidden sports romance. It just says that the role model quarterback has his morals tested with the head coach's rebellious daughter. That's all I know about this one, but I really enjoyed Fair Catch, and I know Blindside has been blowing up everywhere, and everybody's been obsessed with it, so I am looking forward to another Candy Steiner sports romance, and I love a good forbidden, and I love it when it's the coach's daughter, so I sounds like I'm gonna love it. Okay, and then the next one is King of Wrath by Anna Huang. This comes out October 20th, and all I know about these are that they're like billionaire romances. I don't know if she's released anything about these. I actually forgot about it until I was talking to my friend Tori from Novel Life about doing this video, and she sent it to me, and I was like, oh yeah, that is coming out. I completely forgot, and I feel like she just released her last book, so she's giving us a lot. But this one, it just says steamy billionaire romance, full synopsis to come. So it's coming, and I'm gonna read it. Okay, I have a lot of November books, so we're gonna get through these. The first one is November 3rd, and it is The Brawl by Willa Nash. I remember I was talking to my friends, I think it was in the live show for the Clifton Forge series, and we were like, wow, she's not coming out with the next book for so long for the Eden series. And I'm like, is she not releasing a lot of books? She's releasing her Devney Perry one, A Little Too Wild, in what I said, October. And then she's releasing a Willa Nash in November. And then we're gonna have the Edens in 2023. So this one is book 5. I haven't started the series yet, but I definitely want to read it, hopefully before this one comes out on November 3rd. So this says that he was in Montana for a week, and he spots the most beautiful woman in the world, but he doesn't believe in love, and he wants to go on a date with her, and she's sworn off men, and he doesn't take rejection well. So a kid asks to hire him as his lawyer because he wants to sue his teacher about a bad grade, and his teacher is our heroine. So sounds interesting. I need to read the series, and I'll get to this new release. I skipped one. So we have Kiss Her Once For Me. This one comes out November 1st, and this is the same author that wrote The Charm Offensive, which I absolutely loved. And so this one, it's a sapphic romance, and one of the heroines is going to, like, fake date slash fake marry her landlord because she needs help with money and he needs to get an inheritance, and then she ends up falling for his sister, and it sounds really good. So it also takes place at Christmas, and the meet cute is at a bookstore that leads her to fall in love, and her new fake fiance, who they're gonna get a marriage of convenience with, she falls for his sister. So That sounds really cute. I'm really excited. I'm excited for something new from this author because I loved The Charm Offensive last year. Then we have The Villain I'd Like to F anthology. I do have The Duke I'd Like to F, The Rake I'd Like to F. Have not read either one of those yet, but I will at some point, and I will definitely buy The Villain I'd Like to F to add to my collection because I really love all these authors. I just like buy anthologies and don't read them, but I need to. So it's my goal to read those anthologies, and I'm excited for this one. Then on November 15th, we have Before I Let Go by Kennedy Ryan. This one's the only other one I have physically right now, but this is a second chance romance between a couple that got divorced. So that's all I really know about the synopsis, but it sounds very emotional. I've had friends read it and say it's very emotional. So a new Kennedy Ryan, yes please. Then we have two that come out on November 22nd. We have Astrid Parker Doesn't Fail by Ashley Herring Blake. I could not spit that out, but this one is book two. Delilah Green Doesn't Care, which I absolutely loved. And so Astrid broke up with her fiance. Astrid was a sister from book one, and I really liked her character. And so now someone asked her to be the designer for the hotel's renovation that's going to be broadcasted on a popular home improvement show. And I guess she says yes. And then the woman's granddaughter and the lead carpenter for the renovation ends up catching her eye. And I think that they don't get along because they have different opinions about what they're going to do with this inn. And they end up falling in love. That sounds really cute. Oh my gosh, I'm very excited. I loved the first book, so very excited for another one from Ashley Herring Blake. Then we have Chloe Lisa's new release, which is Two Wrongs Make a Right. This one comes out again on November 22nd, and this one says opposites become allies. So they don't like each other, and then their best friends end up setting them up, and they're like, we didn't like each other. And then they decide to get revenge on their friends by fake dating, and then having an obnoxious breakup, but then fake dating turns into real feelings. That sounds really fun. I don't think I've ever heard of a synopsis like that. It does say that's a reimagining of Much Ado About Nothing by Shakespeare, so sounds good. I have three more left. So in December, we are gonna have Magnolia Parks 4. I don't know who the characters are. The author might have said so, but I honestly don't remember what she said. I don't think it's Magnolia and BJ again. It's gonna be different characters, but I do know on her Instagram she did say we were getting a new one in December. Nothing else I know about that. We are also getting Anastasia by Sophie Lark in December. That's all I know about that. There's no cover or anything, but I do know it's an Anastasia fantasy retelling, and that's all I know, but it's gonna be so good. She pushed back the release because she wanted it to be perfect, so it's gonna be perfect. I'm very, very excited for that. And the last one I have is Caution to the Wind, which is last because there's still no date. I feel like it was supposed to come out in like March or April, and then Gianna's social medias got hacked, and she is not releasing the book until she has full control back from them, and she is claiming it has taken months. I don't know when this book is coming back. She got one social media back. I'm pretty sure she got Instagram back, but she's still not posting to Instagram. She's waiting for Facebook, and it's been like 4 months since this book was supposed to come out. She said at Book Bonanza was supposed to come soon, and that was 2 months ago, so I don't know. I'm just gonna sit and wait, but hopefully this comes out before the end of the year. We'll see. It's Axeman and May's story, and I'm very excited for it. And those are all the books that I can't wait to read coming out for the rest of the year. Let me know if you have any releases that you're excited for, and if I missed any, I would love to know. As always, thank you so much for watching, and have a good day. Bye.